Hello, by Destin, the Gamer Gecko here. Today we have some more Destin news. This is going to be a segment I do every week where I just basically talk about recent things that has happened on YouTube, real life, and just a bunch of other things. Oh my god, you are not going to believe this. Obviously, because since a lot of people are saying that 5G is the cause of the coronavirus, I'm wearing protection gear just in case me using YouTube gets me infected. I'd rather not die now, thank you very much. So let's get into this week's news. Originally I was talking about the Call Me Cost and Katrina situation. However, I don't want to get into that. That's about cheating and stuff, and that's the couples thing to do. I'm not gonna get into that, so we're gonna talk about other shit. China. Oh my god, we have been talking about China lately. China Gohoshana. There's some cheese in here. So if you don't know, China has recently banned people playing online games with foreign people. And what I mean is, China's basically going to try and force servers into their own country and not let foreign players interact with people in China. Well, this is not as bad as the Hong Kong riots. This is really scary that China is going to this length to basically hide the people from foreign news and aid. Basically, China's already in a lot of trouble, but no one's doing anything about it. If you don't really know, first off, China, it's not explicitly known, but China has not been reading reports about how many deaths and people are infected with coronavirus right now. They're trying to make it look like they got past it finally. However, Inside News does confirm that that is, just like my ass, a lot of bullshit coming out. Second, they got into a lot more trouble because they're kicking Nigerians and stuff out. Only blacks, by the way, not Chinese people infected with corona. Because basically in a restaurant, which again, they're in quarantine, you should not have these open, so China. I do need some water, hold on. No, I don't wanna. I'm really scared of you, I need to stay 6 feet away. Alright, there we go. Anyway, but this is, in my opinion, super scary, because, again, this is, China's been all over the place lately, and no, am I saying it's the Chinese people themselves? No, it's the Chinese government. A lot of people are gonna think I'm being racist when I say China. I meant the actual government running China, not the people. The people themselves don't want this either. Unless they believe into the Chinese ideals, then. Well, it's kind of too late to help them then. But this does cause a bit of a problem. Because this, again, a lot of what China's doing, its government, not its people, infringing on human rights. The Hong Kong riots, in my opinion, should have been enough to actually cause an actual conflict. Lily, they put these, I forgot what they're called, but these bombs in onto the floor and stuff that basically are filled with boiling hot water and they explode. So not only are you being boiled alive in some areas of your body, or your entire body if you're not careful, but you will have shrapnel, again, blazing hot to the point where it will fucking fry your skin more than my classic fried chicken recipe. Maybe one day we'll do a Cooking of Destin show. But, China's already done a lot to the point where it should get in trouble. The UN is full of a bunch of pussies, and I'm just gonna be honest, it's just kinda stupid watching our government be destroyed. Not our government, China's government destroy its own country. And no one's doing anything about it. I know, again, I'm just kind of using the gaming thing as an example. China is basically going full North Korea on its people right now. I'm positive they're not going to allow anyone from other states or countries to come in soon. And it's a really scary idea that China is going to be a larger North Korea. And unlike North Korea, actually have weapons that can cause a lot of damage. So hopefully we can do something about this. If not, I don't know what to say. It's just, it's really scary times in other countries right now. This is loud. You will obey me, machine. But in other news, Destiny's player base is actually really low right now. Bungie's actually in a lot of trouble right now because they kind of admitted that the new Master Nightfall things, whatever they're called, the 1024 light one, 1024 light level Nightfalls are kind of more for streamers and stuff than actual people. It's kind of sad that Bungie is now kind of abandoning its own player base and trying to become popular. Because you haven't noticed, I haven't been playing Destiny a lot lately. I don't think I mentioned in my other videos, but it's just Season of the Worthy is fairly unfun and not with a lot of content. Now, the leaks are true and there's going to be like SIVA stuff involved. Don't get me wrong, I will play in a heartbeat. But god fucking damn it, dude. Why is the game in such a bad state? Bungie hit the nail with Forsaken. And then Shadowkeep, even though Shadowkeep was a bunch of reused content, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying Shadowkeep is the best piece of Destiny content. I will tell you firsthand, it is a bunch of reused assets. The first time I played it, I was amazed. Now that I've had some time to think about it, Bungie just sold me content that was I had in Destiny 1 and charged me double the most of the DLCs in Destiny 1 for it. And people say I'm the bad guy. But yeah, it's really sad that Bungie is kind of using the fear of missing out trend as an excuse to make more money. If you don't know what that means, fear of missing out means it's content but only in a time frame. And that's what Bungie is doing. They did it last season. And the last season was actually kind of cool. But then, I realized this content's never going to be in Destiny again. And it's stupid. It's sad. Because Destiny was a big part of my life. It was a big part of my significant other's life. It was a big part of a lot of people's lives. And now Bungie's just kind of throwing it around like a whore. And I really hope they can fix this shit. And hopefully by the next expansion or next season, they stop with the fucking fear of missing out content. I don't want to have to fucking play instantly to know what's happening. Just let me play when I'm ready, damn you. Release me! But my face is getting better than this. It's really hard to breathe in here. But yeah, it's sad. Bungie is not doing good right now. Other news. XCOM is having a spin-off game. What? Oh god, fuck. It's water time. I wear this stuff to the volunteer things I do. But yes, XCOM is, oh my god. Vapes are not that bad, don't trust what they tell you. So yeah, it's kind of weird saying this, but XCOM, a game that I kind of play on my off time, is having a spin-off game where you are actually the Lego Space Police, basically. So yeah, this is called XCOM Commander Squad. It takes place after XCOM 2. If you remember XCOM 2, the aliens won and took over humanity and basically was using us for DNA. Oh, I don't mean the fibers while draining us of our balls. No, I meant our body. What? But basically, this is kind of like the XCOM apocalypse. What was it called when it's a prequel? No, it's not a prequel, it's a sequel, but a spinoff. Basically, this is gonna be before XCOM 3. And in my opinion, it's gonna set up XCOM Apocalypse. If you don't know, XCOM had XCOM 1, 2, Terror from the Deep, and then Apocalypse, but the new ones are kinda changing that formula. So now we have XCOM Chimera Squad. Chimera Squad will not have makeable characters, but will have a preset of characters that range from humans to aliens to half humans and aliens. Each one will have a specific abilities and its own character. So a lot of people would be sad by the no permadeath mechanic and stuff, but you still will have a fun cast of characters to play with and new abilities to use. Again, it's basically like a space police. You're basically a SWAT team trying to take down a gang of human and alien gangs and stop the city from having havoc. So yeah, I really hope it's a good game. If not, it's not coming out the console as we know, but when it does, I will be one of the first people to play it. And hopefully, folks, XCOM Chimera Squad will be the premise for the next XCOM game afterwards. And lastly, before we go, if you haven't noticed, Doom Eternal's new event has ended, and we are in Event 2, which will have very brand new enemy skins and weapon skins. I've been playing Doom Eternal a lot lately. Let me say, fun game. I am enjoying it to the point where I have been chiseling my pants every day. So I'll probably be doing a live stream of Doom Eternal. Maybe I'll do Doom 2016 before I do the Eternal playthrough. But I have finished Eternal, and let me say, beautiful game. I love it. I have never cheered so much in my life. So I am running out of time, so I am Desmond Gamer Gecko. All jokes aside, guys, please stay the fuck inside. We are in a crisis right now. Guess what? If you stay inside, by next month, everything will be open back up. Oh my god, Destin. I don't think that's possible. Trust me. Just stay inside, little boy. Yeah, and also, like I said earlier, there is a lot of volunteer programs at a lot of places. Please, if you want to help people, sign up for them. Usually 3Square are running some of them in my state. Again, if there's anything that can help out people less fortunate than you, you should do it, and you should do it as soon as possible, unless you are old or have a weak immune system or anything that can get you sick and possibly killed. Stay inside, be safe. I'm Destiny Gamer Gecko. I'll see you later. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe for more content, and don't forget. I forgot what I was gonna say. Alright. Bye bye.